What's up, YouTube? So we're here today on TVOS 10.22 to jailbreak it with the Green Goblin jailbreak. So this has been a long time coming. I'm pretty excited for it to run the latest Nitto TV on the TVOS 10. So we have an Apple TV 4 here. It's on TVOS 10.22, which currently today on Saturday the 10th is being signed. So if you guys have one of these Apple TVs kicking around, I would suggest you downgrade. I have a downgrade video already out for it. Downgrade, and then you'll be able to use this. You'll also need City Impactor, just like most modern jailbreaks that we have today. So you should already know how to use City Impactor. You can use this with a free developer ID, but you will have to re-sign the jailbreak every I think it's like 7 days or something like that. If you have a developer ID like I do, it's for a year, so you don't really have to worry about re-signing the application. So the main thing you need to do is grab the IPA, just like every other jailbreak. You'll grab an IPA, you'll download it, you'll have it in your downloads folder here. You'll need to open up City Impactor. Now, you will need a USB Type-C cable plugged into your MacBook or PC. Into the Apple TV 4, and you can power up the Apple TV 4 and have the HDMI plugged in so you can see on screen. You basically drag this over and drop into City Impactor just like every other jailbreak. Now, I actually left mine here because you do get this error. This error is normal, and I don't want you to worry about it, so don't even bother clicking anything here. You can see it's already showing up on my device. And once it shows up on the device, that's all good. So you can just hit OK and you'll be good to go. That's all we need to do on the computer. We're now going to move over to the Apple TV itself. So here we go. Now this can take multiple tries and it will probably fail a whole bunch of times during this video. But we just got to stick to it, and eventually we'll get jailbroken and Nitto TV will be available. So here we go. So you can see there, that is the first jailbreak fail, and this could fail like multiple times, but you just got to be patient and continue to run this after the device reboots. This isn't going to hurt your device, it's just the nature of the jailbreak and the exploits that are being used. They're unstable to get jailbroken, but once you are jailbroken, your device will go to sleep, wake up, you can remain jailbroken for a very long time. I've had it where some of my devices will stay jailbroken for like months. So even if you are using a 7-day certificate, you can just make sure you're jailbroken and you stay jailbroken. Don't reboot the device or have a power outage or anything, and it'll just stay jailbroken. So we can see it failed right away. So I'm just going to fast forward through this and we'll eventually get jailbroken. So here we are, guys. We are now jailbroken and we have Nitto TV. So you can see here, Nitto TV is basically like a Cydia. It's a package installer. So it allows you to install different packages onto your Apple TV that are not available in the App Store. And that's kind of the whole purpose behind jailbreaking. And that's why jailbreaking thrived so much for so long before kind of going stagnant. So this might actually bring things back. It's really cool. Anyways, you can do things like install Plex, which is probably the first thing that I'm going to do. Now, there might be some issues, but we'll see. You can see here, we just respring our device. And here we go, we have Plex. So that's kind of like a demo. There'll be other jailbreak tweaks that'll be coming out for the Apple TV. And I'll be covering a lot more of those, like installing Kodi and stuff like that, which I'm hearing rumors right now is not functioning. So if you guys are jumping on that right away and it doesn't work for you, hang tight and we'll take a look at how we can get Kodi up and running with the latest build. But thanks for watching, guys. That is how you jailbreak your Apple TV. You do need some patience, but like I said before, the jailbreak is very stable once it's going. So now that I'm jailbroken, I can just leave this device and it'll be fine. It'll go to sleep, it'll wake back up, it'll still be jailbroken, and it'll run for a while. I heard there is a kernel panic that can happen during video playback, so we'll have to see how that pans out. But for the most part, if it's anything like it is on iOS, it should be pretty stable. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Or what are you excited for the most with your jailbroken Apple TV? I'd love to know. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys again next time. Cheers.